Understanding our universe and the laws that govern it allows us to shape the world in which we live. With support from the U.S. Department of Energy and the National Science Foundation, particle physicists at American universities and national labs are making significant progress in pushing back the frontiers of knowledge, including the recent discovery of the Higgs boson. This discovery led to the 2013 Nobel Prize in Physics for François Englert and Peter Higgs for correctly predicting the particle's existence. But the story of the impact of American researchers doesn't end there. Mankind has asked certain questions for as long as anyone can recall. Questions of life, death, existence, and the very nature of the universe itself. While not all such questions have been answered, there are some for which science has made tremendous progress. For instance, we now know that the universe began about 14 billion years ago in an unimaginable explosion called the Big Bang. The universe has been expanding and cooling since then, leading to the familiar world in which we live. Another question about which we've learned a lot over the past few hundred years is the ultimate nature of matter itself. Abandoning the now discredited elements of earth, water, air, and fire, we are now certain that matter is made up of atoms. Atoms are made of protons, neutrons, and electrons. And the last 30 years has taught us that even the protons and neutrons are made of smaller building blocks called quarks. When you combine these building blocks with four known forces, we can describe everything in our universe. These forces are gravity, electromagnetism, and the strong and weak nuclear forces. However, not all mysteries have been solved. We have discovered a substance called antimatter that is the opposite of ordinary matter. The problem is that we see a lot less of it than we expect. We don't know why. Further, it is quite possible that quarks and leptons are not the smallest building blocks of the cosmos, and it's equally possible that there are other forces still to be found. Until recently, scientists could only speculate on the origins of mass, and it was only in the summer of 2012 that it seemed that we might have finally answered that question with the discovery of a particle called the Higgs boson. The laboratory at which many of these important questions might be answered is the CERN laboratory in Geneva, Switzerland. There are several detectors, weighing many thousands of tons, which are arrayed around a huge particle accelerator called the Large Hadron Collider, or LHC. One of the biggest and more complex is called the Compact Muon Solenoid, or CMS. The CMS detector is enormous. It is 50 feet high, 50 feet wide and 70 feet long, and it weighs over 14,000 tons. The best way to describe it is as a huge 100 megapixel camera able to take 40 million pictures a second. The detector is so large that it takes over 3,000 physicists to operate it and analyze the data it records. The pictures this detector takes are of collisions between pairs of protons traveling at nearly the speed of light, recreating the conditions that were common when the universe began. Using this constant barrage of collisions, scientists collect data that allow them to better understand the laws that govern the universe and to get closer to finding answers to timeless questions. The CERN laboratory is a vibrant international research facility, drawing physicists from around the globe. The single largest national group of scientists that work on the CMS detector are faculty, staff members, and graduate students from American universities and laboratories, and they have designed important and technologically challenging portions of the detector.
The U.S. has made major contributions to this CMS detector, to ATLAS, to the whole program. And in particular, we have in the U.S. been really key in the tracking system to the calorimetry, offline software, computing, essentially every realm, and including all of the analysis. Many, many of the papers, many of the Higgs analyses had very strong U.S. involvement. And in fact, it's a worldwide community that the U.S. is part of. And it took that big push from the U.S., as well as all the other countries, of course, to make this program a big success.
Significant technical work was performed inside the U.S., although eventually all the components and many of the researchers traveled to CERN. Once at CERN, scientists consult with colleagues from around the world. Scientific results are critically evaluated in large meetings and in small groups. Sometimes the most crucial conversations occur one-on-one in the coffee shop in Building 40, which houses offices for physicists working on the LHC. Visiting CERN is scientifically intense, but there are also opportunities to relax, from games of frisbee on the lawn to hiking and skiing opportunities in the nearby Alps. Strolls along the scenic Lake Leman and Rhone River in downtown Geneva are added benefits. But for all the amenities of Switzerland, the thing that brings U.S. physicists to CERN is the science. If you ask a physicist why they're there, a common theme emerges.
I work at the LHC because it is the world's largest and most energetic accelerator, and this allows us to study some really interesting physics at CMS.
The LHC is the highest energy particle collider in the world, and it's the best place to explore the basic nature of the universe.
I do research at the LHC because I would like to be a part of the next big discoveries in particle physics, because I think they will happen here.
Over the next decade, the LHC and the CMS experiment will be probing the very frontier of knowledge. While the observation of the Higgs boson was the first discovery that will go into the textbooks, it certainly won't be the last. CMS is an international collaboration filled with world-class caliber minds, and researchers from American institutions will continue to play crucial roles.